Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see all about LED guys. So I hope everyone knows what is an LED. So it is nothing but a light emitting diode. So basically, I hope everyone saw my photodiode tutorial guys, because it's 100% similar to that. Okay, so now let us go through this for now. So basically, it is a diode, right? Light emitting diode. So the basic symbol of diode is this, right? Okay. So it's going to emit the light. So I'll be drawing the directions. That's it. That's what our diagram guys. So positive, negative, anode, cathode. So that's what our LED symbol. So now I hope everyone got a small or a slight idea on this guys. Okay. So basically these light emitting diodes are the most widely used of all the diode types of semiconductor diodes available today and are commonly used in televisions and color displays. Okay, so it is a type of light emitting diode. Okay, that's mostly used in different types of semiconducting diodes available today and commonly used in TVs and color displays. Okay, so it is basically a heavily doped PN diode. Okay, it basically works in the forward bias, emitting a large amount of radiation. What is nothing but radiation is nothing but the energy guys. Okay, so basically this is how it works guys. Okay, so let us go through that so that it will be really clear for you. So basically it is a really simple process guys. Okay, so let us go through that so that it will be clear for you. So basically when you give a forward bias for a PN diode, this will be our depletion region guys. I'll be writing as DP. So depletion region. Okay, so I hope everyone is now clear with this diagram. So basically this is our P type, this is our N type, and this is our depletion region, in which they both are combinedly formed covalent bonds. Okay, so basically as you increase the power supply for this guys, if I keep on increasing the power supply, so if I assume this as silicon, I'll be increasing up to more than 0.3, so that it's going to break it. Okay, for silicon it is 0.7, sorry. So up to 0.7 it's going to withstand, and after 0.7 this depletion region is going to be vanished, right? So at that exact span of time, the energy, we know that E is equals to hc by lambda. I hope everyone knows this formula. So as E varies, we can define lambda is equals to hc by E, where we have C and E are the constant values guys, right? So if you keep on increasing this supply, so these bonds, everything will break, and these two will start recombining, and that forms an energy, right? So that energy is equals to hc by lambda. So lambda is equals to hc by E. So with change in E, as you keep on increasing the forward bias, you are going to get different wavelengths guys. So basically wavelengths determine the color guys. Okay, so now I hope everyone is now clear with this. So by varying the E values, you're gonna get these many different colors. Violet, that's just the range of those visible region guys. Okay, so basically violet is from 380 to 450, and blue 450 to 495, green 495 to 570, and yellow 570 to 590, orange 590 to 620, red 620 to 750, like that it moves on. So if you increase the voltage, the current is also going to increase. That is nothing but our intensity. Okay. Okay. So now I hope everyone is now 100% clear with this guys. So we will be going through one more thing. That's nothing but according to this topic, its characteristic graph guys. That's what I thought to say you, explain you. So basically VI characteristics for this is nothing but similar to our diode. So it's just following our PN diode, right? Right? I hope everyone understood that. We are applying forward bias so that it's just following our PN diode. So that's nothing but it will be like this. So basically the only difference is that for silicon it is 0.7, right? The breakdown voltage or cutting voltage, right? Cutting voltage is 0.7. But for an LED, it is really high. It is almost 1.632, 3.6 volts. Okay, guys. So now I hope everyone is now clear with it. Okay. So basically this LED can also be connected in reverse bias, but the voltage should not exceed 5, guys. So even this applies in negative or reverse bias also, guys. Okay. So, but the only problem with reverse bias is that it is not possible above 5 volts. It should be less than 5 volts. So now your question will be something like this. So what are the materials we use for creating an LED? So basically the LED is made up of gallium arsenate. So that's a combination which gives an infrared light. So basically I hope everyone has a TV remote in your hand, right? So basically the TV remote, when you click the button, there will be a red light, but it blinks and it's off within minutes or seconds. Okay, so that light is made up of this thing, guys. That's an infrared or infra LED. Okay, so basically the normal our mobile screens and everything are made with this compound, gallium arsenate 1 minus x phosphate x. So for different colors, as if you observe our TV, it's going to have different colors. Okay, so now I hope everyone is now clear. So if you go through the applications, those are nothing but remote controls, optical communication. Advantages are nothing but we'll be having a long life, it's going to be low power supply, we need low power supply, and the action is really fast. Yeah, that's a noted point. So, and these are more efficient, as if in our homes, when we switch on a bulb, it's going to be hot in some time, right? I hope everyone knows that. So those bulbs cannot withstand up to few long years, but these are going to withstand, guys. So these are more efficient and no heat is generated. And we also have some basic disadvantages, guys. So I have told you that it should not exceed 5 volts, right? If it exceeds, it's going to get damaged. So cannot withstand above 5 volts and cannot be used in open areas, guys, as the light intensity will be a bit less. Okay, so now I hope everyone is now clear with this topic. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through liquid crystal display. Thank you. Thanks for watching.